James had to stop at a signal at Abbey Station. He hoped no one would see him. But Thomas Edward Henry and Gorton were there. Gorton chuckled. "I wonder who's going to be going to London tonight," he said.
"I expect it'll be you," replied Henry. "James is too silly to go to London. He doesn't even know how to date female engines right."
James was very cross with Henry. He was the reason why he'd been trying to set up a good date with Lisa. His boiler bubbled, his face turned red, and he glared at Henry as he huffed and puffed like an angry bull looking at a red blanket. Henry could see that James was looking at him angrily.
"What? What?"
he asked. Then he quickly realised.
"It was about what I said, wasn't it? Oh, crap."
James was too cross to go back to Tidmouth, so he decided to sleep at Knapford Yards. "Ugh, am I glad to be home," he huffed. "And first thing in the morning, I'll be around back at Tidmouth Sheds and give that Henry a piece of my f***ing mind," he said crossly.
"What? Another piece?" said his driver.
"Well, I think he'd given in quite enough back at Abbey Station. It wasn't his fault you volunteered to double-header a train to London with Lisa. And you've got no one to blame but yourself for being angry with Lisa." James knew that his driver was right.
"I'm never going to be showing my face on the island again," he puffed sadly.
Then he heard a puff and a chuff and a whistle. It was Lisa.
"Oh, Lisa, what are you doing here?"
"I just want to apologise," he said sadly. "I didn't know that meant so much to you."
"What made you think of that?" she asked.
"Well," said James, "did your boiler ever want to ask something, but your funnel was too afraid of what the answer might be?"
"Sometimes it's best not to ask those questions," said Lisa, "but sometimes we should cherish what we already have, like a very special friendship. If you accept my apology, we could be special friends, and something like me wouldn't change for anything in the world," finished Lisa.
James smiled. "Something like me wouldn't change for anything in the world?"
"I'm glad," said Lisa.
"But," finished Edward, who heard everything, "saying those words, saying that you're both meant for each other, can make both engines nervous not to know each other."
"Exactly," said Lisa. "You're all such experts."
This made James feel a lot better. He couldn't be cross anymore, and instead began telling Lisa all about his job as a mixed traffic engine. And the very next day, James was back at work, a much happier and kinder and wiser engine. He now knows that when there's a new engine about, all he has to do is be himself. He had picked up more important passengers than ever, and he is also happy to have Lisa as his very special new friend. And Lisa thought the island of Sodor is the most wonderful place any engine could live in.